you, Holy Spirit. We welcome your presence here. We thank you for what you are doing, Lord. You are here, Holy Spirit, to comfort us, to help us. He's Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Testimony of what heaven has done so far for us. I know some people are still taking exams there, all right? And I really want us to look at the concept of faith. I don't know if I thought on it on Sunday, right? Did I? Did I? Or oh, it's in CI. Oh well, we are going to have a put it another twist on it. So even if you're there in CI, you're going to see hear something different, but still the same topic. Basically, we want to see results. We want to produce results. That is basically it. Christian life without results will always lead to frustration. So it is my desire to make sure that you produce results. Amen? And you can if you want to. That is something that I am very sure of. If you want to produce results, you can. But we need to know on how to produce divine results. Now, many times, a lot of us will say, I have faith, but I didn't see the manifestation. Now, it's simply because we don't understand the dimensions of faith or the dimensions of belief and stuff like that. So tonight, we're going to be talking about faith, belief, and hope. Faith and belief, they're not the same thing. And also hope, they're not the same thing. We need to understand this. So we'll study a bit of faith, study a bit of this, then we'll round the whole thing together and put it in one picture. So that you know how these things function. Without this, you can't get to this. Without this, you can't get to this. Without this, you can't get to this. I want you to know that they are one picture, but we need to see how they function so that it can begin to produce results. First of all, you can't be talking about faith if there are no proofs. James says, show me your faith without your works, and I will show you my faith by my works. Say, I will what? Somebody says, show. What does that mean? Something what? You can see. Say, show me your faith without your works, and I will show you my faith by my works. So faith produces or has got an evidence called what? Works. And then he said, faith without works is what? Faith without works is what? Dead. Look at somebody saying you have faith, but it might be dead. Listen, everybody here has got faith, but not everybody's faith is alive. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. We are all programmed to have faith. There is nobody here that does not have faith. The question is not if you have faith, because you have. The question is your faith alive or dead? James said, faith without works is dead. Certainly there are faith that are dead. They are dead faith. It is faith, quite all right, but it's dead. So I've seen many people that say, I have got faith. I had every faith. Where is the works? Something meaning, when you enter into the realm of faith, there's always will be an evidence to prove. This is my faith. Something must happen to prove. Not something in the spirit, something physical. So until you are seeing a physical result, I can actually tell you, you might still be in these two realms. And I'll show you. Now, many times we talk about belief, amen? Many people have asked me, what's the difference between belief and faith? Many times I don't explain immediately because I know we're going to talk about it in the church. Because many times we talk about these things, oh, I believe. What does it really mean to believe? Something happens when you believe. Something happens when you graduate into faith. Something happens when you have hope. In the realm of hope, we begin to talk about expectations. What you are seeing. What are you expecting? So faith is proven when there is an evidence. So until there are works to prove your faith is dead. The Bible said Abraham believed God and it was accounted for him for righteousness. He believed. The Bible didn't say and he had faith. Read your Bible very well. The Bible did not say he had faith. He said he believed. At the end of the day, he got the fruits of his belief, Isaac. And then, having a proof of what he has believed, his faith. And that is Isaac. And then God needed to what? Allow him to be tested on his faith. Now, you are not permitted to be tested when you are still believing. I was shocked. When was Abraham told, by God, you're going to have a kid? Amen. At the age of what? Please, do we have Bible scholars here? At the age of what? 75. When did he eventually have got Isaac? 100. How many years gap? 25 years. It took the father of faith, in quotes, 25 good years to produce his promises. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. Don't say hallelujah. Your own will take 25 years.
Amen.
I'm about to share with you why you are better than Abraham. Amen. By the reason of covenant.
Amen.
Why you can produce yours tomorrow or today. Amen. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. Father of all, you know, father of faithful, all this and all this. Glory be to God. We honor him. Because he's the one that started this faith business. But it took him 25 years. And within that 25 years, can I ask you a question? Did he sometimes did not believe? Or walk contrary to the promise given to him? I can prove that by the time the wife looks, waited, and the wife said, hey, let's stop waiting. Look at my maid here. Just enter. Amen. You know, just go in, sleep with my wife, with the maid, and let us get this stuff done. You see, sometimes when we are still growing in how we believe, we start looking for shortcuts. Because we are not ready by patience to let our what? Faith, comfort, mature. We want what? A shortcut. I see that in ministry, Lord. See that in ministry. People want a shortcut. Now, he went in, slept with the maid, came out, Ishmael came out. God said, that is not the one I want. That happened within that 25 years. That action alone depicts somebody that at some point did not stand for what heaven said to him. He wouldn't have done that if he was all powerful and all strong as we made it look like. I'm going somewhere. So after 25 years, there is Isaac. Then you know what happened. At some point, God said, well, take this proof. Show me your faith without your works, and I will show you my faith by my works. Faith without works is dead. A very powerful statement. So, how do I differentiate faith, belief, and hope? The only way we can do that is to go through the Word of God. Then we'll understand what, when we believe, what happens. See, when you are in faith, is the results. We are talking about results immediately. That's why the Bible says now, faith is in the now. Faith is this moment. I preached that message somewhere and somebody came to me and after service said, but we have faith, but we don't receive. I said, you don't have faith and you don't receive. You're only believing. Believing produces the performance. And I'm going to show you. When you believe, you activate the move. When you enter into faith, you produce the results. Instantly. There must be something to show for your faith. And I'm going to prove it. So, faith does with the results, amen. Belief deals with the process. Hope deals with the concept. Did you get what I said? When you are hoping, what are you hoping? You are developing something. I'm hoping that I'm going to be rich. Then I believe I'm going to be rich. Then I have faith I'm rich. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. They're just looking at me. The reason why you think you are in faith and you're not producing results is because you are not in faith. And then, why do we even misunderstand faith? It's because we don't even understand the element of faith. What is faith? The best many of us will think about when we talk about faith is when we think about reading the Bible and then Rema comes, you know. Yes, that is true. But when you understand this, faith comments. Faith comments. Even if faith is existing already. You are not the one producing. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. You are not the one producing faith. Faith comments. So, if you don't have faith, there is faith around. As you are seated, no matter your own belief, there is faith around you. Because somebody else has got faith. There is a person called faith himself. And I tell you the truth, you cannot always be healed by your own faith. There might be somebody here that his own faith will cover you up. We're showing the Bible. We don't understand faith. And that's why many of us struggle in the kingdom. Because your father can, by his faith, cover you up. But because we don't even understand the how can he cover you up? I don't have to struggle. No wonder sometimes when your faith is weak, the Bible even commands you to go and agree with another person.
So as you agree with the person, you are now operating by that person's faith, not your faith. So if faith is personal, that means another person's faith cannot work for you. So faith is an entity of heaven. So I'm here to show you what that, you know, you see, you can, I have walked out and prayed for an unbeliever that had no faith, but still got healed. How is that possible? I'm here to tell you something. Faith is always needed for heaven to move or to function. But let me tell you the truth, even the Father has got faith. God, the spirit of faith gave you the gift of faith. He can't give you what he doesn't have. So he's the faith himself. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. So, do you know that Jesus went on the cross? God sent his son on earth based on faith. He believed that someday you're going to agree and say you are my Lord and personal Savior. He operated on that faith. So many times, we don't really understand it. So faith cometh by hearing. I don't know if I can use somebody. Yes. Call you faith. Who can I call faith? Come. Come. Stay there. All right. Faith cometh by what?
Hearing.
By what?
Hearing.
Say amen.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
So, can I hear her say amen? Am I looking at her? But I can hear her. Simply meaning faith does not function by sight. I'm just telling you some of the things. Faith does not function by sight. So faith comes by hearing, and by hearing the word of God. So the word of God is what conveys faith. What brings faith to you is the word of God. And who is the word of God? And the word was with God, and the word was God. So who is the one that brings faith to you? God. Jesus himself. So Jesus is faith. That's why Christianity is likened to be faith. In this faith in which we walk. So Christianity is faith himself. So what is faith? Faith is not just something you read out of the Bible, but faith is a person that makes himself available. Oh, you have faith. You don't even understand. Go and sit down, sis. You are too quick to want to go sit down. Amen. See, men, relax. I know you've read books on faith. Just relax. See another dimension, another side of it. This will help you produce results. Sometimes people come to me, I have been having faith. I say, you don't have faith. I'm very raw. You come to me, I don't think this faith thing works. That's why many of you are frustrated, because you believe you have faith. But no results. So you are frustrated. You stop even because you didn't get results. Even your hope is gone. So today we are going to be studying these three dimensions to actually understand how to operate in these things and produce results. Should we go deeper? Thank you, Father. So there is Abraham, 25 years, then faith, producing results. So this is the proof. So if you met Abraham with the maid inside of the room, his works at that moment is not showing you faith. So at that moment he is with that maid, his faith was what? Dead. Because the question here is, many of you feel that all these guys, or all these great men of God, let me call them like that, so that I don't offend religious people. All these great men of the old, that they were all perfect. I will tell you what happens that will make you lose your promise. But lack of faith doesn't cause you to lose your promise. It simply limits
the manifestation physically of the promise, but the promise is still there.
So, what really happens when we believe? What happens when we believe? When we say, I am believing God, I believe. What really happens when you believe? I said here, faith produces results. Belief is a process. Hope is a concept. So let me put it the other way so you understand it. Hope gives you the concept, the idea. When you believe in what you hope for, it's the process. It starts running out. Angels are moved into motion. When you enter into the realm of faith, physical manifestation of what you have, well, the substance, the evidence. Faith deals with substance, evidence. We're not getting there yet, but let's understand what happens when you believe. Very simple, there are places in the Word of God that talk about if you believe, something will happen. If you believe, something will happen. It didn't say if you believe, it has happened. But when you believe, your belief system activates something to happen. Go to Luke chapter 1. And this kind of message is the kind of one I've had ministering and they put it online. I have to go listen to it. Because I know I need it. Today, if you know where I've been, Luke 1, are you there? Luke 1 and verse 45. And the Bible said, there said, and blessed is she that believed, for there shall be what? There shall be what? So when you believe, what happens? A performance. So first thing that belief will do is what? To cause something to be performed. So when you step into believing, you activate the performing ability. When you believe, then something is performed. Blessed is she that believe, for there shall be a performance of what? Of those things that are what? Spoken to her, what?
From the Lord.
So what do you believe? The word. Your prophecy. I want to end this thing here. Please. Because I've seen people say these things. I can't remember if he's here, if that person is here or somewhere else. So don't think I remembered you. That's why I'm correcting it. I used to hear people say something like this: run after the word of God and not prophecy. Prophecy is from where? Is prophecy what? A word from God. Is it not the same thing with the word of God?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know where I saw that. Don't run after prophecy, run after the word. Let's not just divide what heaven himself. Prophecy is God's word. The word of God is God's word. Every of them is what? The same. Teaching is prophecy. As I'm teaching you, I'm prophesying.
That's right.
Prophecy is not when I say, there's somebody here. Your name is this. Your name is this. If that is what you understand as prophecy, you are limited in the school of prophecy. Come on. There are four dimensions of prophecy. So I always say, run after them. We shouldn't even differentiate that. You are prophetic as a being. Many of you don't understand what I said now. Now, let's look somewhere else. John chapter 11. Are you there? John 11 and verse 40. And Jesus said unto her, said not I unto you that if you believe, you shall see. Did you see that? If you believe, what happens? You shall see. So, belief always causes something to happen. First one, if you believe, there will be a performance. Here, if you believe, what will happen? You shall see. So, belief will cause something to begin to happen. When that happens, that is faith. Because that is when you have evidence. I don't know, I'm talking to somebody. Now, somebody will say, well, today I'm walking in hope, tomorrow I'm believing. No, no, that's not what I'm saying. I'm only saying that you can have hope, believe, and faith right now and produce the results right now. Right now. But sometimes there is a bedrock of this system that is missing. That even if I carry the biggest faith and come to you, if I can't find that, I might not be able to change the situation. Now, can my faith produce for you results? Yes. In the Bible, many instances, the centurion said, my servant is sick. Please, can you come and do something about it? And then Jesus said, I've never seen such a great faith. That simply means, now, faith himself has declared what this man has been believing for is now complete. So he left, went home, and saw the servant healed, and inquired at what time the servant was healed. And the Bible said, and it was at the same time Jesus said, I have not seen such a great faith. Simply meaning, when faith appears, there must be an instant result.
Amen.
Somewhere. Whose faith healed the servant? So my faith and produce for you that blessing you are looking for.
Amen.
Do you believe in me? That's
yes.
A prayer.
Amen.
Somebody came to me and said, I want to be your child. I don't know what you call son. I said, do you understand the concept? You know, many people that call you daddy don't understand the concept. I said it here once. You don't call me your daddy and you are struggling financially. You don't call me your daddy and you cannot lay hands on the sick. If you cannot do what I do and you call me your daddy simply because you don't understand what you are saying. There is nobody I call daddy. If I say this one is my father, watch what I do. I even do much more than they do. I do much more than they do. And don't call anybody your father who is not willing to bless you and say this, you will be greater than me. You are into somebody that wants to limit you. I'm telling you the truth. Access. The son of the kingdom that didn't, the prodigal son, you know the son. When he got angry that the father restored the prodigal son, what happened? The father said, all I have is yours. You could have taken what you wanted. Simply meaning, what your father has got, you have access. If you truly honor your father, you have access to do what he does. Listen. No student can be greater than the teacher. No servant can be greater than the master. I said this here. Your father can only, the best your father can do for you is to produce him in you. But if you must be greater than your father, you need to channel by the Holy Ghost. If you have anybody that teaches you, you can't be greater than them until a greater teacher teaches you. And that is the limitation of this generation. We end with our fathers. That my father won't do anything does not mean I shouldn't do it if I'm led by the Spirit. But I seek permission. I honor and say, oh, well, many times I've been called and said, this stuff you do, where, how do you do it? From my fathers. We've never seen it like this.
I saw some people just changing clothes spiritually. Yeah. That they are removing dirty clothes and they just wearing new clothes. I see favor landing upon you greatly in the name of Jesus. If you believe that, say it better. Amen. Yeah. The Lord said to me, He said, the day will come, and that day is now, when you speak, your eyes will be opened in the spirit to see what is happening in the room. Yeah. So, two witnesses. Jesus said unto her, did I not say to you, if you believe, you will what? See the what? The glory. So, to see the glory of God, you need what? Very simple. How many of you believe today? The Bible said, as we behold his glory, like in a mirror, we are transformed from one degree. One day God, you know, the Holy Spirit quoted that place for me. I said, do you know the mystery behind it? I said, I talked. He said, no, you didn't understand that. He said, as you behold, you are transformed. Simply meaning, the person that will see the glory is not the perfect one. Because the person that needs the transformation from one degree is the person that's already low. So the people that will have access to see glory this season, are not the people you think. There are people who understand that I need to see so I can be transformed. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody. As we behold, we are transformed. And I said, Father, I'm a candidate. I'm only preaching the word. So people are looking at me strangely. If I start manifesting now, those people, they won't even come back here. I don't know why some people are looking at me strange. Believe, you shall see. Believe, that shall be a performance. So what happens to Mr. Hope? Is somebody's name Hope here?
My mother.
Amen. Amen. To understand the concept of hope, the Bible says something, it says, Christ in me, the hope. So what do you do with that hope? You don't end in the hope, you need to graduate in the school so that you begin to produce the glory. He's simply saying, so far as Christ is in you, there is a hope that something great will come forth out of you. But you don't stay in the hope. You just keep hoping. Hope is so important. People are becoming much and more hopeless. I'm telling the truth, even in the church. People come to church with nothing to hope for. They are just here because I have got to be here on a Wednesday evening. And on Sunday, people will trouble me. We just come to the church to fulfill what? No matter if they are sitting in front or at the back, it doesn't matter. They are those that are sitting in front. They can't even look at it. They can't stay focused for 5 minutes. I wonder why they are in front. Now people in front are looking at themselves. Is he talking about you? Is he talking about you? Hope will activate your concentration. When you have hope, your expectation rises. Hope is the foundation for a great faith. Hopelessness will cripple your faith. And that is what we are going to listen right now. You will know what cripples your faith when and my faith meets with your hope, it will produce for you results. But if I come to you and there is nothing there, a million times zero will produce nothing. Many of us, we are hoping for really nothing. We have hope for what?
I need a car. What kind of car? Lord, I'm hoping the Lord will give me a car. And then you are walking on the streets and you see a place they put a car, 2,000 lira. And the car, the boot is like this, the boot is like this. And then on your pocket or in your bank account, there's 2,000 lira. Automatically, what you are hoping for is a reality.
Man.
Listen, I will shock many of you. Lord, increase me financially. And then I come to you and give you 10 lira. Did you increase financially?
Yes.
Oh, you're saying no. You had more than 10 lira. More. You increased. The challenge with many believers today is that we are not specific. We are hoping for hoping. We are just hoping. What are you hoping for? What are you hoping for? Abraham. The Bible said, and Abraham hoped against hope. What was he hoping for? He would get what? A child. Heaven deals with specifics. Even God deals with specifics. He said, let us make man. He didn't end there. Because today, if you look around, there are many kinds of man. But God, let us make man. He didn't stop there. He said what? He became specific. In our own image, after our own what? Likeness. He didn't stop there. He said, let them have what? Dominion. Look at somebody says specific. God was and is to today. When God calls you, he will be specific. That's why calling and being chosen is on a different dimension. One is more specific. Not everybody called will fulfill their calling. There are many prophets that will never fulfill their calling. Many apostles will never. Many men of God will never. Many people destined to be rich will never be rich. Let's understand that fact. That is a fact. Many are called, but what? Fear chosen. And if you listen to where they made that statement, you understand the wedding. They called some people. What happened? They gave excuses. The way some of you young people are giving excuses. Listen to the story before he said many are called, few are chosen. A man prepared a banquet and said, let me call the friends. Let them come and enjoy with me. Simply meaning, come into the kingdom and walk. He came to one and said, I've married someone, some people, I got boyfriend. Some people, I've got this. Some people, I've got this. You know? So when people, they didn't want to come, he said, all right, go into the streets. Get anybody, anyhow, anybody, just come. The Bible said, and they came. And when the person that called was walking through, what happened? He saw one that was not wearing what? The right apparel. What's it? So he said, take this one. Put him where what? In the total darkness. And then the statement, many are called. That simply meaning, for you to be chosen, there is a need for your response. You must respond. Later say, yeah, I know I'm called when I finish school. Don't let the school finish you before you finish it. So you've got like some minutes to talk on hold. So are you specific? I'm not going to be specific tonight. What kind of God? You can hear, wow! God, you give me a precious husband. What kind? What kind? I love one of of the teachings by Creflo Dollar. I don't know how many of you have seen that teaching on relationships. Say, ask questions. Yeah. He was just listening to us, to this stuff. And then as I was listening, I was looking at myself and said, Jesus, Jesus. I hope I'm qualified. I hope I'm qualified in this. Ask questions. Be specific. I didn't say his name. You can call somebody's name. Somebody came to me and lady came to me and said, "Man of God, do you know what the kind of man I want to marry?" I said, "My man of God." I said, "Just that?" He said, "Yes." I said, "If you come to church next Sunday, just stand up. All the guys you see seated down, they are men of God." They are men of God. A man of God is not the person that is preaching on the pulpit. That is just a pastor. So if your definition is, I want to marry a man of God, yes, it could be that person sitting by you, not me. There's how many men of God everywhere. I just use myself as an example. I didn't say there's a situation like that. Jesus. Be spiritual in the name of Jesus. Go out right now and say, "Hey, hear Pastor Obi today. Pastor Obi, you style and be hitting for people, right?" I didn't use style to hit anybody. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody said, "How can I do that?" The Bible said, "He put the desires in your heart, for He placed those desires in your heart." So when you prayerfully write them down, you find out that there's somebody somewhere that heaven has got in store for you. That is saying, he that findeth a wife does not mean you want to enter good or ultimate search. Is that looking from pillar to post? That's not what the Bible says. Yes. Trying to look for something. Now, Hebrews 11. Let's go to Hebrews 11. We understand now, let's try to wrap it up by understanding the concept of faith. Thank you, Jesus. Are you there? Hebrews 11 and verse 1. Very popular place in the Word of God. Hebrews 11 and verse 1. He said, "Now, faith is what?" Now, we've talked about hope. We're about to talk about hope now, but when we can't talk hope until we begin to see the concept of faith. Now, he said, "Now, faith is the substance of things what? Hoped for." So, simply meaning, faith is what? The substance of hope. So, without hope, you can't find the substance of faith. Faith, first of all, faith is what? The substance. What is the substance? Substance of things hoped for. So if you remove hope, faith's equation is not complete. Faith is the substance. What is the substance? It's something, something that you feel, something that you touch. A substance. Faith is the substance of what? Things hoped for. So when you begin to hope, that hope produces what? Substance of those things. And that is what we call now faith. So you know that faith is not faith. Faith starts when you start hoping. And hoping is something. So faith is the substance of what? Things. What are the things you are hoping for. I'm hoping for what? I'm breakthrough. Many times I have people here. What do you believe God for? Is I'm gonna make it. They think they are wise. I will make it. Make it how? Make it how? For example, they are doctors, but they are doctors that specialize in fields. Oh, I know I'm going to make it in business. What kind of business? You see, that's why many of us can't produce any kind of substance, because we are not hoping on anything. Our hope is not on anything. Our hope is everywhere. I'm hoping it shall be well with me. Yes, hope. On what are you hoping on? On what? Need to be specific. So, the substance of the things hoped for. So, what I hope on that thing, the substance of that thing is faith. So, what is the works? The works is the substance. So, show me your faith by your works. When you begin to produce the substance of those things you are hoping for, that is faith. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. Then the second one says something, the evidence of what? Is there any lawyer here? Any law student here? What is evidence? When they say evidence, what is that? Proofs. Amen? Proofs. What are proofs? Something you can see. A witness can come and say, I witnessed this. But without what? Evidence. Evidence is a physical stuff. An exhibit, something you can see to kind of conclude the matter that this stuff that we have been saying all this while is real. So, faith is the evidence of the things not seen. So, the evidence that I'm expecting something that is already in the spirit is when what? I see it. That evidence is faith. So, faith without evidence is dead. Faith without substance is dead. Let me challenge you today. You need to start looking for your evidence. Why? Evidence of things not seen. So the Bible said the things that are seen are created or made by the things that are not what? Seen. Simply meaning my faith, when my faith is actualized, the dimensions of the spirit is made physical. The word was made flesh. There is nothing given to you by promises of the word of God that cannot be made flesh. I told somebody one day, a leg that is cut like this, we will tell the leg to grow.
Amen.
In your eyes, you will see it. The leg will be coming out. Now, many of you have seen it. What's been made flesh, but you don't know that that is it. When legs are growing out, what is that? Bones have been added. Grow, come. It's coming. What happened? Bones are. So that is words made flesh. So one day somebody without eyes will say, well, we give you a new one. And in front of you, we will form. And some of you are looking at me. When will that happen? It will happen. Who will do it? I'll be the first if you're not going to do it. There will always be somebody to do it. So what happened? Substance of things hoped for. Evidence of things not. That is what? Oh, I have faith. Show me your evidence. So what happened? When I have hope and I believe in what I've hoped for, I begin to produce. I don't know who is doing that. He should be careful. Don't want to get upset. He has been doing that and people have been going there to warn him. Next thing, he will take something home. And I'm not joking. I know how to be very humble. I know how to punish. Now, what is the concept?
Hope.
Hope, right?
Yes.
And you believe in the hope, right? What do you hope for? And you produce what? The substance, which is what?
Faith.
You produce the evidence, which is what?
Faith.
So faith is substance. Faith is evidence. I'm sorry, if you have no evidence, no substance. Probably you are still believing there's a performance. You are still creating the concept. So if I come with my faith and I meet your hope, my faith can produce for you. Now, let me give you an example. Should I leave? Still got some time. There will be results tonight after tonight's service. There will be results. So here's the woman with the issue of blood. If I might just touch the hem of his garment, I will be what? That statement comes from hope. She has seen something, expectation, and she believed. And she went. Amen? And then when she got to Jesus, she touched. And then there is Jesus. Virtue left me. Who touched me? People wrong you. Why do you complain? He said, no, virtue touched me. And the woman came. And then he said, thy faith. Simply meaning your moment of completion with evidence is here. Thy faith has made thee whole. I'm sorry to say, your believing might not make you whole. You believe in Jesus, right? You believe he died for your sickness, right? He took your infirmities, but you are still sick. You can't graduate into the faith in divine healing and still be sick. Because it's a finished work. Be shocked, but that is the truth. Faith is faith. Faith is real. You can't say faith and still be experiencing the opposite. I'm sorry. Faith is real. It's either you are faithing. Now somebody say, but faith is evidence. Faith is substance. Do you know why I mentioned initially it took Abraham 25 years? It's for you to understand that when faith comes, it comes with evidence, and nothing can take that evidence again. So, if I touch the hem of his garment, I might or I will be made whole. And immediately he touched, he was made whole. So, are you going to touch something today? Are you going to hope on something? Are you going to believe? Are you going to depend on your faith? Look at the person sitting by you. Say, do you have faith?
You have faith.
If the person says yes, say, where is the evidence? Do you know the best person to pray you into blessings? Another blessed man. Because he has got a substance to release. I always say it. And except God is leading me to somebody, there is something I always look for. Before I can go to you to impact me on a particular thing, I must see the fruit, the substance. Because I Nothing will flow to me except virtue, except substance. If I'm doing better in healing, you've never healed anybody, I can't go to you to impact me with gift of healing. You have, don't have it. So what happened? The best person to pull you into the completion of that faith is the person you see already walking in it. So watch this grace, watch this ministry, what it can produce, what you see evident, you can produce and receive. Faith. Results. Substance. Evidence. Works. James was actually saying that in regarding to works, like what you produced. I once heard Oyedepo say something. He said, in this school of faith, you cannot stand up to somebody and claim to be an equal until you have produced what the person has produced. I didn't understand that statement. In the school of faith, it's not mouth, it's proofs. I know many of you here, you claim to be giants of faith. I'm sorry. If you have nothing to prove for it, just keep quiet until what your proofs can prove that your giantism in the spirit. Without that giantism, keep quiet. You only make mockery. I know some people that they will challenge anybody, and including pastors. But I have got nothing to show. Calm down. When you are able to pull and build something, then you come out, you become authority. People look at it and say, okay, we can see the results. Jesus said, if you don't believe in me, believe the works that I do. Simply meaning, people can cease not to believe you. Somebody said to me, Pastor, people can criticize you, but they cannot deny what you are doing. They know there is power somewhere. They can't criticize, but they can't deny the power. They can't deny what you do. Jesus said the same thing. He said, if you don't believe in me, believe the works. Simply meaning, the evidence of who you are lies in the works. I'm not talking about spiritual things here. You are who you are spiritually. But on this earth, heaven requires a manifestation. So today, there is faith here. Do you have hope?
Yes.
Many of you need to rekindle your hope right now. That hope you've lost on this nation, I beg you. Your family issue is possible. Have hope. Believe. There's a performance. Believe, you will see. Is it not? When you believe, you see the glory. When you see the glory, is you are in faith. When you see the performance, so may the spirit of faith reach you right now. In those things that you are hoping for, I release faith upon them in the name of Jesus. Catch the faith of God now. Faith cometh by hearing. Can you stand on your feet, friends? Faith cometh by hearing. Listen.
Can you say, can you hear the sound of faith? You might hear. You might not hear. But I hear. It's about the word of God, not prophecy. I said, come on, Abraham, they lived by prophecy. They lived by what heaven spoke to them. That's what made them who they are. So let's not differentiate the two. Listen, I'm here to tell you the truth. You know what I see in the spirit? Let me say it again. People are removing their old clothes.
Amen.
And people are entering into a new dimension from today in the name of Jesus. Now you know you cannot afford to lose hope. Because the substance of what you hope for is what your faith is. So without faith, without hope, you've crippled the manifestation of faith. Except you go to somebody who has got the faith. But the person needs something in you to function. That is hope. How many of you are hoping for something great tonight? Open your mouth and tell the Lord what you are hoping for. Be specific, hope for those things. Friends, this is a simple message, yet very powerful.
How I love calling your name every day.
Just on the keyboard.
Your name is the same. How I love calling your name.
Look at me, brother. In the eye.
Every day.
I hear the Lord saying, a testimony is coming your way. The challenges are over.
Oh, how I love calling your name.
Can you declare what you are hoping for right now? Can you believe it? Can you believe it? I activate it right now in the name of Jesus. I command that right now, anything that is destroying your hope leaves your life right now forever. In the name of Jesus. I speak that your eyes be open to understand the concept of heaven. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Time has always been our enemy. But we'll start beating time soon. Where are you from? No. Please lift up your right hand. I'm closing down. I want to minister, but I can't minister because of time, so you can catch the bus. Lift up your right hand. Father, today, out of the faith in this ministry, let the spirit of faith be released.
Amen.
To meet them right now in the point of their believing, in their hoping, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I command an instant result.
Amen.
From this night, an instant result.
Amen.
Command a miraculous result. From this moment, a miraculous result. A change in that dimension right now.
Makarabayataya. Something is happening here. The challenge is, if I get to you and I release something into your spirit, if I start speaking, you will respond. Because already I spoke something of faith in you. That is what happens. The dimensions are here. The dimensions are here. Lift up your hands as you begin to receive yours. There's an anointing coming here right now. There's an anointing from the left to the right. Lord, I release the spirit of faith in this room. Yokes will be broken now. Yokes will be broken. It's happening right now. It's happening right now. It's happening right now. It's happening right now. The dimension of God is moving here. It's happening right now. It's happening right now. You can take yours. You can take yours. You can take yours. Paribo soto parabaya katato. I see lives being changed now. Dimensions being changed. Families being changed. Every wrong foundation is being changed right now in the name. It's happening. Every wrong foundation is being changed right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak the power and the fire of God. Move! It's happening. It's happening. Ma potropa intante. Open your mouth and just begin to receive it. May you be anointed right now, from the hair upon your head to the sole under your feet. It's happening, it's happening, it's happening. Nabruko aritos igroma andrebates. Mantrepe suntrabades. Something is happening at the back there. Hallelujah. Calling your name. Bring her up. Come. Every day. Your name is saying, Masha Tabraya. How Lord, calling your name. Glory be to God. My Jesus. Every day. Your name is the same. Look at me. Lift up your hands where you are. I see yokes being broken. Every struggles in your life, every addiction in your life, I command right now, let them leave. Every spirit that is not of God, I command them, let them leave. Let them leave right now. Leave. Let them leave right now. Leave, leave, leave. I command every spirit at work in anybody's life. You can hear me, all you dubious spirits. I command you to leave. Leave, leave them. Leave them alone right now. I cut off every connection. Leave. People are being set free. People are being set free. You will not struggle anymore. Hold your neighbor by the right hand. Just hold your neighbor. Hold your neighbor completely. Hold your neighbor. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for what you are doing. There are 20 persons here. Heaven said to me, I will touch them before they leave. I don't know where they are. But the fire of God is going to come upon them. Immediately those 20 persons are touched. Already the fire of God is hovering over them right now. They are feeling it right now. It's already happening. He said, these ones, their lives will never be the same. He said, these ones are entering into the realm. They shall be pillars of faith. It's already happening right now. In the name of Jesus, I release it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wherever they are. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 20 of them. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Right now, Lord, let your power be released upon them. 20 of them, they won't be able to stand it. They won't be able to stand it. That one, I'm sure they won't be able to stand it. The power of God will just touch them. They won't be able to stand it. 20 of them, paribo, oshata, tapata, pata, pata, pata. Wherever they are, right now, it's happening. It's happening everywhere. It's happening everywhere. They won't be able to stand it. They won't be able to stand it. 20 of them, 20 of them. Lord is saying, 20 of them. Wherever they are being filled with the Holy Ghost. They are being filled with the Holy Ghost. They are being filled with the Holy Ghost. These ones are special. They are graduating in the school of faith. They are going to be pillars of faith. They are being built up into pillars of faith. Right now, in the name of Jesus, let the power move. It's happening. It's happening. It's happening. 20 of them. I see 9 remaining, 9 in number remaining. It's happening. You won't be able to stand it. You won't be able to, your legs are beginning to shake because of the power that will come upon you right now.
It's happening. Yokes be broken.
Remaining five of them. Lord, by your mercy, locate them now. By your mercy, set them free. By your mercy. Moko karata dia soto proto gobaya. It's happening right now. Five remaining. Maliko pradende si supras. Father, I give you praise. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Let her go. Thank you, Jesus. Let her go. It's done. Lift up your two hands and thank the Lord. It's done. Faith in your life, the completion of what heaven has started. God bless you. Pick up your offering. Pick up your offering quickly. Thank you, Father. Pick up your offering quickly. Maybe your tithe envelope, your offering envelope. You can just stand on your feet and come in here and drop it. May the Lord bless you. See you on Saturday. Saturday is the first meeting with the great man of God that is coming, Chris Morgan, ACIUT Block. Please, I invite each other.